There are no easy answers. We've made the decision to remain online. So the second half of last semester was done online. We had a summer term that was done online. And this next semester is also going to be online. But there are institutions that don't have the same capabilities that we have with regard to online learning. The teachers may not have access. They've not had training on how to do this well. Their students may not have access. For the lower levels of education, kindergarten, primary school, secondary education, online is going to be a very difficult option for them to do, and this teaches all of us that we should prioritize the intense use of technology to supplement what we're doing in the future so that we're better prepared. I think that the role that educational institutions have in shaping the role of Africa really are two things. One is developing the kinds of ethical future leaders who are going to create an enabling environment for everyone. And the second is developing a productive workforce. Those are the two fundamental things that educational institutions are doing. We also have a responsibility in helping to shape the future that young people imagine for themselves. The stories that are running in their minds about what they're going to do, who they're going to be. And if we do all of those things right, then the changing demographics of Africa in the next 30 years will be a big economic opportunity for the continent. Because increasing population, increasing productivity, providing goods and services to that booming population presents great economic opportunity for everybody. Do not lose hope. Do not despair in the face of this emergency. We're going to come out of the other end. And if we conduct ourselves with determination, we're going to be okay.